Okay, this time I'm going to prep a tooth number 17, 18, 19. 19 is the mandibular left first molar, and this is this articulator does not have a gingiva because I take this gingiva off because it is too thick, so it doesn't have good tooth exposure, so I took it off so that I can have better gingival extension and better prep. This is the different type of articulator that I had a video with last time. This is made in China, and this is made in USA maybe. Fasaco. This is Fasaco articulator. I don't know whether I have pronounced it right, but this is unknown. As I buy this phantom head, it went along with this. So let's begin with the round burr. I like to initiate my prep with the round burr. Let me adjust my loop. The loop that I'm using is very nice. Comparing to other ergo loop, it is affordable. Okay, slightly more than 1 millimeter. Good. Correct them. Kude! Wake up! My fiance is resting from her study. And it has not that big contact, but it is having like vocally, it is oriented vocally. So let's drill this much. Come on. Let's plan first before we move on. Let's plan the outline form together. Alright, so here, let's mark the contact area first. This is the contact area and this is the contact area. And let's mark 0.5 clearance that we need to achieve here and here, right? So now put some mark on the prominent cusp. This is the cusp, so this is the tip of the end of the cusp, right? End of the cusp, end of the cusp, end of the cusp. End of the cusp. Distal cusp. This side is the distal. And the medial. So the curvature, S curve should be 90 degree, right? 90 degree. Like this, and this one just like this. So I have to cut just a little bit here, and I'm going to include the lingual groove and just slightly. Oh, good. And then for this, I can go a little bit more like this. I can include this topical groove, but you know, sometimes people skip and it goes like this. And here, give a make S curve like this. Okay, let's include it this time, assuming that there is a caris. And we can follow and it needs to be internal line, internal angle. Angle must be 90 degree, 90 degree, and 90 degree. The width must be 1 millimeter, the isthmus. And yeah, the gingival floor also must have 0.5 clearance, right? And this side wall must be converging, right? So keep in mind, last time on tooth 29, I didn't make it converging. So for this time, let's make a good convergency. Okay, let's get. ask the patient to tilt the head a little bit. Excuse me, could you please turn your head toward the left side? Okay, I will do that. Thank you very much. Like this. Good. He is a very cooperative patient. Excuse me, could you also move your cell phone? Thank you very much. He is a very good cameraman. Okay, good. Now Michelle side. I think my patient, you need to move to the previous position. Could you please cooperate? Thank you. Incline more. Yes, okay, thank you very much. Cameraman, are you okay? I think you're doing good. Look at my hand, how I'm supporting this, holding this handpiece to safely drill the tooth. You must have adequate or good strength to hold the handpiece. So let's change our bar to 245. 245 is a good bar to make nice proximal bars in depth. It is 0.8 in width. Now Let's make it a little bit wide, slowly, because the round bird is too small. So if I just go in deep, I might damage the personal surface. Okay, good. Let's ask patient to move her head toward the right side. So, moving the head of the patient is one of a very important skill for you to prep your tooth nicely. And yeah, don't be shy. Okay, thank you for your cooperation and compliment your patient. I need to make the gingival wall perpendicular and make the buccal wall converging, and check with how far you can go deep to break the contact. So the end of the bird at 245 is 30 millimeter in length. So if I go fully in depth, I achieve 3 millimeter. So thus I can break the contact thoroughly. So now, incline your handpiece and make the point of the bird towards the buccal side to make convergence. You see that I broke the margin, and you can see the good clearance. It is a very it has now I have achieved very good clearance this side as well. I think I need to go deeper here, since this molar has a flat contact, so I need to go deep like this. I removed the gingiva because with gingiva gingiva is too much, like I think that gingiva is a hypertrophied gingiva, so it is covering too much tooth surface. I cannot reduce the tooth surface. So I went this deep. Let's see, without seeing occlusally, I can have a safe cut, because I know how I'm doing. I have a good protecting shell, and I know that my angle is right, because I'm along with the long axis of the tooth, so I can safely go deeper. So keeping the long axis is very important. Here I have hatchet to break the contact, break the shell, which has been protecting the tooth. Let's widen it a little bit more. Oh, my finger aches as I retract the rubber chick. In this situation, it is good to use gingiva margin trimmer. And let me use my dump technique. Let's give some pepper. It is optional. Okay. My hand is aching. My thumb is aching. This little tooth is tough. But I think this tooth is softer than the other type of rock. Okay. Now let's move our boat to 330RGS, which is, I mentioned it again, Dr. Svensson likes this bird. Since he likes, I also like it. Following the type of tree. Okay, I have credit. I have included lingual groove and make this visual S curve. Let's deepen the purple flow a little bit more. This needs to be, the depth of the purple floor must be at least 0.5 mm. I have smoothened the initial part, and now go to the distal. Hold the burr, hold the handpiece very firmly. Be careful with the sharp edges. Okay, and then using the round burr, let's make the distal distal vocal groove. Let's include it here. And also and move to 330 arches. Always think of a long axis of the tooth. And around the angle. I don't know where from this black one comes from. Okay, now the purple floor is flat. There is some discrepancy. So it has been smoothened. Now check the proximal bus. I think I need to use 169 to I see irregularity and the actual wall is not according to the outer contour, so let's use 169. I need to be very very careful. Oh, I think it'll be also good to use hand instruments. Let's use hand instrument. I don't want to risk my beautiful track. Burr is so powerful, so I might damage my beautifully prepped tooth. So though it is somehow quite laborious, let's do this. So if the hand instrument is too dull, here is the sharpening stone. And let's sharpen a little bit. Holding this instrument 45 degrees to the surface and push. It is getting hot. Okay, this is the final polisher, not polisher, sharpening stone. Let's see how it has been sharpened. Ah, there you go. It is so nice to sharpen the instrument. It feels so different, you know. It just stops, it doesn't see itself. But it catches the surface and it brings them down along as I press it down. So you hear very good sound. I think it is the time that I oh so sorry my dear patient. Don't be afraid to be my patient, okay? Actually, I'm very gentle. I like this case. Dr. Stevenson even said it is much easier to do the natural tooth than this type of one. I don't know in what point he mentioned that. But if that is the case, then my finger. It is almost done. Make it a little bit more sharp. Convexity. Okay, good. A little bit more. This 169 is too sharp because it is a new bird. So dealing with this, you need to be very careful. I need to be very careful, not you. This much is just enough. And then give a nice cut with hand instrument. Let's see how cleanly I I'm using this sharp point of gingival margin trimmer to define the internal line angle of the distal proximal box. I think there is something. I feel like I'm fishing. There is some big fish inside. Okay, my thumb is almost KO. Less cards, less do that. Actual pulpa lining. Nice bevels at the crown, and the amalgam will not break. Right? This one is the distal margin. I think this side is less than 1.0. You see, I need to widen this with my thumb again. Oh. It's so fun. Let's enjoy. You see, now it is the time to use mass meter. It is only 1 millimeter deep. How about here? 1, 2. Now here too. At the middle portion. Thank you. Let's let the enamel hatchet run through its mouth, because it is 1 millimeter in width. Oh, fail. Oh yeah, pass. So here, only the meatball side. Cameraman, I'm so sorry. It is too rough. I'll look at it. Let's smoothen it. Let's use the power of thumb. You are the thumb. Don't you chuck? Hey, cameraman, you're casting a shadow. Slowly. Gingival margin trimmer. Mr. Gingival margin trimmer, where are you? This one is for distal surface, but to define the this side is too small for it to approach. Good. I should not have too much aggressive. I'm almost done. What I need is just a small modification to refine the internal line angle. It should not cost too much. Alright, so this is the secondary cutting edge. The side of the hatchet is good to smoothen the pop-up wall. And lastly, hold on a moment, it is sloping, so let's try to fix it. your operation becomes big. It came big because I wanted to make the floor even. Alright. So 1 millimeter clearance. Oh, my thumbs are aching. Okay. 1.2 millimeter. 2 millimeter. 1.5. 2 millimeter. 1.5. Perfect! Woohoo! Let's see. Oh, my thumb. Oh, my eyes. Oh, Xuan, you did a good job. Let's evaluate my beautiful work. Okay. Please score me. Score my work. Good clearance. Good clearance here. Slightly a little bit more. Okay, but it is still. How many millimeters do you think it is? Yeah, 0.5. Puede. In Tagalog, it is puede. Okay. Here. Slightly a little bit more. Okay. Make it better clearance. Gingival floor is perfect. Okay. Outline is beautiful, I think. It's really nice, I think. Right? Too much exaggeration? Well, if it is good, then it is all by God's grace. He strengthened me, but if it is not, then it is all my fault. Always good things come from God, that's what I know. I made a huge mistake that I didn't bevel the distal side, which is difficult to be seen. I thought I did beveling well. But the distal part, which has been untold, unseen story, has not been trimmed well. So next time I'll do it better. Please forgive me this time. It was supposed to be a beautiful like this. Okay, so here also. Okay, other than that, it looks okay. And here. Okay, it looks fine. It looks pretty fine. It looks pretty fine. Here. How do you think? Good convergency on the functional cusp side. Good convergency. And here, the walls are all converging. Here, all the functional cusp on the buccal side is well converging. Okay, that's it. Oh, how about the proximal tooth? Proximal teeth must not have any damage. Do you see any scratches? For this time, very micro scratches, but made by the hand instruments. But other than that, clean. Okay, I hope we all pass. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye, my thumbs. Let your hands rest very well. Take care. Bye-bye. See you. Today is D-Day, D9. And so, 9 days, 8 days more to go. I'll prep another tooth. in this afternoon. This is 12 o'clock. See you.